Why are you doing what you're doing? You have to start with why, because most people don't know what they're doing. They imitate other people. They just go with the flow. They often pursue someone else's idea of what they're supposed to be doing. Say they read a book of a successful entrepreneur, or they see a friend of the family, or they watch the Social Network movie or whatever, and they think, I can do that. And they try to pursue someone else's dream. But for 2 years, when I was 20 years old, I worked at Warner Brothers, and I was the guy in the tape room in back. So often, these like famous rock star musicians would come into Warner Brothers for a meeting with the executives, but then they would kind of come hide out in my tape room for a bit to kind of catch their breath before going in to meet with the suits, right? So I got to meet a lot of pretty miserable rock stars. And I think it's because a lot of them maybe set out on a certain trajectory when they were 17. They had a dream that they wanted to be a rock star on stage. And by 25, they did it. They were a rock star and they got famous. And at 35, they're still doing it because that's just all they knew, where they were on a certain trajectory, but it didn't actually suit them anymore. They were pretty miserable. Or maybe when they got there, they realized that this isn't what they really wanted. Maybe they just wanted fame, but they didn't want to have a boss, and then they sign a major record label deal and they realize they've got a boss. So whatever it may be, I just found that you need to know why you're doing what you're doing. Otherwise, you're just gonna go on the wrong track for so long. So the worst case scenario is you don't wanna end up with this deathbed regret, where at the end of your life, you find that you've pursued something that someone convinced you should want instead of what really works for you. And then you're left with this horrible feeling of like, no, what did I spend my life doing? It's like, well, you should have asked that earlier. So let's start with this. What do you want? Look at this list of things here. Money, prestige, fame, leaving a legacy, or freedom. Whatever one or two appeals to you most, that's fine. Just totally go for whatever appeals to you. No matter which you choose, somebody will always tell you that you're wrong and you should be doing it for other reasons. But you just need to be honest with yourself. Some people actually get really excited by money, and money is the real reason they're doing things. Fine, if that's what you're into, just admit it. The key point is to know what it is and to focus on it, and don't diffuse your energies trying to be everything to everyone and trying to make sure that nobody tells you you're wrong, because somebody's always going to tell you you're wrong. So for example, if you know that money really excites you and you really want to make a lot of money, then fine, you can refuse fame, let others take the spotlight, and you can be one of the people that just focuses on the numbers. So I lived in Los Angeles for 8 years. Yeah, I lived in Los Angeles for 8 years, and I met some movie stars. They're out on the street and everywhere, and I got to know some. And the funny thing is, often surprising that they're not as rich as you'd think they should be. But on the other hand, some of the richest people in Hollywood are the ones you've never heard of, because they made that decision early on that they're going to stay behind the scenes. They're going to make the money and let others kind of be in the spotlight, walk the red carpet, and all that kind of stuff. So if you optimize your career for making money, you can make a lot more money by just admitting that early on, that you'll let others take the fame, take the spotlight, leave a legacy, whatever. If you want to focus on money, just focus on money. As another example, legacy. I lived in New York City for 10 years, and if you go around New York City, you see the word Trump everywhere. It's like Trump Plaza, Trump Towers, Trump this, Trump whatever. I even drove 2 hours upstate into the countryside and saw the Donald J. Trump State Park. And I thought, what's with this guy? Like, why does he have such a need to put his name on everything? Like, there have been plenty of real estate billionaires for centuries before him that didn't have such a need to put their name on things. What's with this guy? But then I realized, like, okay, this is his measure. Like, at a certain point, he must have decided that it's important to him to put his name on things, which means that he's decided to make less money by doing so, because if he just lets somebody else put, you know, their logo, whatever it may be, the Panasonic building, he could have just let other people put their names on the building and he could have just been the owner. But no, he wanted his name on it, which is a decision to make less money, but more legacy. On the other hand, you can optimize your life for freedom. And this is the one that I chose. So I really liked the idea of setting up my life in a way that at any point I could just disappear, or I could just be antisocial and go read books for a month or whatever it may be. So I had to set up my career in a certain way to delegate almost everything, make myself unnecessary to the day-to-day running of my company so that I was free to go do other things. And of course, plenty of people along the way told me I was wrong, and they told me I could be making a lot more money if I were to do it this way, and that I needed to be more hands-on, I needed to be more such and such. But I just say, okay, this is your measure. My version of DIY, which is often known as do-it-yourself, I like the version that says decide it yourself. Other people can do it. You're the one that makes the decisions. You don't have to do everything yourself. So that's it. But whatever you choose, this is your compass. You need to optimize your activities based on what's important to you instead of diffusing them. You might even get these side effects, like you might be shooting for a career of fame. You might want to get as famous as possible, and you might make money as a side effect of doing this. Or you might be aiming for a life of freedom, and you might get fame as a side effect of it, whatever it may be. But the important thing is to know your goal.